And these are today's shoutouts. If you want to see yourself in the next video, then subscribe and leave a comment. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, Arca here, and I'd like to ask you a favor. If you find this video useful, please do make sure to subscribe to my channel. Help me grow, and I'm starting to gift subscribers. More info at the end of the video. Please enjoy. What is up, boys? Arca here, and in today's video, I'm gonna tell you everything that's been added to the new Season 5 update. But before we begin, I'm really close to 5k subs. It's a really big number for me, and it's been a blessing recording these videos on the daily for you guys. So if you feel like supporting a creator, then hit that subscribe button down below if you have not done so already. When we will reach 5k subs, I'm planning to do a V-Bucks giveaway stream. So if that sounds interesting, then don't forget to turn on the noti bell not to miss any of my new streams. Any giveaways or just videos in general. I basically record everything that's happening in Fortnite. Weapon changes, map updates, and stuff like that. And I also record different videos to help you become a better player, like aim assist settings, guides, and game optimization tips. But yeah, this is it for the intro. Let's jump right into the video, boys. So first off, we've got the Mando added with the Baby Yoda into the game. If you don't know Mandalorian, it's a Disney Plus show. I'm a pretty big fan. I watched every episode from season 1, and they're actually making season 2 as we speak. If you have not yet tried it, then I highly recommend watching it. There are also a lot of quests from Mando in the Battle Pass. Two Star Wars items have made their way into the game, so the Mandalorian jetpack and the Amban sniper rifle that can work as a gun and a melee weapon. And for number 2, we've got the Dragon's Breath shotgun and the Amban sniper rifle. And yeah, I already covered the Amban sniper rifle, so I'll tell you more about the damage of the Dragon Breath. The new shotty does 170 plus damage and fires 4 shots at once. It's mega close range and does splash damage, meaning you don't have to aim perfectly at the target to land any shots. So it can also mean if you've got an enemy group in a tight corridor, you can pop off at them and it will take them all to the lobby screen. So yeah, really good shotgun. And this season, we've also got 4 new mythical weapons. And yep, they finally returned the mythical weapons. It's been a long time since we've seen them in the game. And it seems this season, Epic is trying some old game ideas paired up with new game ideas. So the 4 new weapons are the Booms, Sniper Rifle, the Dub, Shadow Tracker, and the Night Hawk. So although previous mythic weapons were usually found by killing the boss AI and enemies around the map, there doesn't seem to be this in this current season. So it's likely these can be found as general loot in loot boxes and just random drops. So yeah, these new mythics are generally more powerful versions of existing weapons, like the Dub is a double barrel shotgun. And for our next feature, we've got the Tilted Towers back. Yes, I couldn't believe it either. It's now called Salty Towers. So yeah, all the salt from all the bad players constantly dying. But in reality, it's actually submerged in sand, thanks to it being on the edge of a desert now. It still does have most of the classic buildings though. You know, like the massive tower block in the middle. And along with the Tilted Towers coming back, there are some new places of interest to explore. There is a Butter Barn, which is a flapjack-themed saloon by the river. The Colossal Coliseum is a huge Roman Coliseum with statues decorating the exterior. And there are 2 futuristic battle locations at Stealthy Stronghold and Hunter's Haven with the epic loot. Like really, there's a lot of loot at Hunter's Haven, so definitely check it out. And for the next point, we've also got a new form of currency in the game, Fortnite Gold Bars. These can be used for a lot of new additions, including upgrading your existing weapons and buying new ones. You can even hire a personal bodyguard to assist you in fights, which is absolutely crazy. You obtain more gold bars by killing enemies, completing quests and bounties, which are essentially new mini challenges, you could call them. And finding hidden stashes around the map is also another good way. Personally, I found that there are a ton of them scattered everywhere, even in little houses in the middle of nowhere. So yeah, just loot every house you can and you'll be stacked with them as well.
And how they work is you got a lot of friendly NPCs now scattered around the map, so they won't attack you, or at least not all of them. And what you can do is actually accept missions from them and complete them for gold bars. It's basically like a bounty hunter mission, where they will tell you to hunt another player in the area. And once you complete it, the whole party gets a reward. So the mission is also timed, so you're racing against the clock with this one. And if you've got a bounty on your head, then you can use a tracking meter to see how close the hunters are on your tail. This will allow you to fight back and not be a sitting duck. It's also a great new feature that will make it so more people interacted with each other in gunfights. Because before, it used to be that most of the players would run around until the circle is really small. But since we're gonna be getting literal missions to hunt these players down, this is a great way to make the game a lot more exciting and fun. And how the gold bars work is they won't be reset from you in every match. They persist in every game that you start playing, so anything but Arena. In Arena, they are reset at every single game. So to spend them, you can track helpful NPCs that walk around the island. So they will have guns, upgrades, and more for sale. You can save up your gold bars for a few matches and then go all out with these vendors to get some really powerful weapons and get an easy dub. And there is now a giant desert area covering the middle of the island, and you can actually use all of that sand to your advantage by remaining hidden. So actually, just simply stand on the sand for a couple of seconds and you'll sink below the surface, where you can then move around with a little small bump showing up on the ground, sneak up on any unsuspecting opponent and then leap out and take them by surprise, and hopefully grab a quick elimination. And if you also haven't noticed, last season was all Marvel themed, meaning all the rewards we had were from their universe and champions. So it was like a deal made with Epic and Marvel, and they literally bought like a whole season. A lot of people thought that the next season 5 will be with some theme as well, but it seems it's back to the roots with this one. So original characters, except for of course Mando from Star Wars. But yeah, a lot of people really thought that we'd get a Star Wars themed battle pass with only skins from their universe, like Chewbacca, Obi-Wan Kenobi, and Yoda. That is because some leaks, which happened before the actual battle pass released, were actually saying that Star Wars skins were gonna be the meta. It was gonna be filled with them, but turns out it's just Mando. Personally, I'm still happy with the Mando skin because it does look insanely cool and I'm such a huge fan. The progression on it works in a way that lets you gear him up to look even cooler. Like in a series on Disney Plus, the actual show, the first few episodes he does odd jobs to get his Mandalorian armor. And with this new battle pass, it's basically the same idea where you'll do different missions he offers and complete unique objectives to get the pieces of loot together for his armor, like legs, gloves and shoulders. But I hope you found this video useful. This is by far not everything in the new season, it's just a quick catch up to keep you guys up to date with the game and anything you might have missed. So if you found this video useful, then don't hesitate to click that subscribe button down below and join the hype squad. Hitting the Noti bell will also allow you to join the Noti gang and be one of the first guys under my videos when I release them. I always read your comments and reply to any questions you may have. So feel free to ask anything or clarify anything from the video. If you also got any new ideas for other videos, then drop them down below in the comments as well. Because it's pretty hard thinking of everything solo. So this channel is a solo hobby I have. It's just like making Fortnite videos for you guys to enjoy, so if you're watching it, then I'm really grateful. And the fact that you're actually watching this video brings me immense joy. So yeah, thanks so much for the support, for all the comments, subs, likes. I really appreciate you guys. So yeah, and as always, see you in the next one. Peace.
What is up, boys? Just a quick message. Basically, I have a Twitch and I have a YouTube account also. And I'm not sure where I should be streaming for you guys. So where do you prefer to watch Fortnite streams? Is it like on YouTube or Twitch? Because YouTube is my main platform by far. On Twitch, I haven't even streamed once on that account before. Of course, I know how to stream. It's like, I'm not a noob. Come on, guys. Leave your opinion in the comments. I will try and read them. And yeah, guys, see you in the next one. Hey, guys, this is the end of the video. I hope you enjoy and find it useful. If you want to join my future Battle Pass and V-Box giveaways, do make sure to easily apply by subscribing and leaving an account with your Fortnite username. I will be choosing 5 random people in the near future for weekly gifts. Peace.